Here is our new engraver.com sharpening system.
Cool.
It consists of a tower and multiple geometry blocks that will allow you to shape and sharpen your gravers without having to think about all of the geometry that you would normally have to do. Today, I'm going to do a small carbide graver. This is a model of this small graver, and we have them color-coded. We also have the geometry blocks color-coded to the models that we sell. The one thing that you will need to work with our system is any kind of a graver blank, and it can be any length to fit your hand, so you don't have to worry that it's a specific size. You will also need a universal collet that comes with the pulse graver. It's the kind that has five different notches around the top. So the first thing I'm going to do is open up the collet and put in the carbide blank. Our carbide blanks have a flat spot on them, and that flat spot is going to go directly underneath the set screw. This is important to index for two reasons. One, so I can tell where the top is, and two, because if the carbide blank ever comes out of this collet, you want to be able to put it back in the same place. Now that I have it tightened in there, for demonstration purposes, I'm going to put a blue mark right down the flat part of this carbide blank to show that it's the top of the graver, just so that it's easier as we go along. Now that we have the blank in the collet, we have to decide what face angle we're going to put on this graver. Our options are 45, 55, and 60. I like 55, so we'll use the 55 degree block. This block will go into the tower like this, and it will hold the graver and go up and down. We want to make sure that the graver is installed in this block where the face, which has the blue Sharpie in, is upside down. To do that, we can look here for the tangs. These three tangs will match up with the indexing slots in our collet. We have five here and three here, so we want these three to go in the middle three of the collet. Another way to think about that is that the set screw will be directly across from these three tangs. So I can put that in there and kind of wiggle it to get it in position, and then pop it right down. To make sure that it is where we want it to be, it's always a good idea to put your graver on the stone and actually look and make sure that's what you're intending. So in this case, the blue side, which is the top of my graver, is straight down. And as we go to make the face, it will be in the proper position. So I'm going to pull my geometry block up here and hold it with my fingers so that it doesn't fall. Turn on my hone. This is a 260 grit diamond wheel here. And I'm going to hold this with a firm down pressure and move it back and forth without rocking it. We don't want to rock the tower. And it has a very nice base, so it shouldn't be difficult, but you want to make sure not to rock the tower. And we're about halfway done there. Okay, we have completely ground a 55 degree facet on the bottom of the graver. It's pretty rough though, because this is a 260 grit wheel. So before I go further, I'm just going to put that down and change to a finer grit. I'm going to do 600 and then a quick 1200. This is the 600. doesn't need much there. And we'll go to the 1200 to give it a pretty nice finish. Now, you could hold this and try to rock back to take the graver off of the wheel, but I think it's probably better if you have downward pressure and just pick the graver up before you move it off the wheel. That way you won't have any chance that you've accidentally rocked and have some sort of an odd facet occur on your face. Now that we have the face done, I'm going to take the collet and the graver out of our geometry block. And I'm going to move to our 90 geometry block. This tells you on the top what is the geometry you're making. It also tells you on the left side and the right side which holes are for the shaping and which holes are for the actual heels when you go to sharpen it. So, the first thing I'm going to do is take my graver, the top up, and hold my block, and we want to do the right side shape and the left side shape. Those are the two holes on the top. I like to do this from looking down onto the graver, just like I would be holding the graver if I was working with it. That way I can see the top of the graver, and if the top right hole here, which would be the top left hole as you're looking at it, I would rotate it to the right, and I would align the indexing slots with the tangs. Again, in this case, the set screw is going to be directly across from the three tangs. So I have the three tangs in the center three of the five indexing slots. You might have to wiggle it a little bit to make sure it's lined up. To put it another way, you should have an indexing slot on both sides that are empty. Once you get it lined up, and then push the graver collet in. It should seat fairly well and not turn at all once you have it seated in the indexing slots. Now we're going to do the right side of the graver. This is going to be to put the shaping grind on, and if you're confused about what hole is what, this is the shaping grind on the top. I'm going to go back to put on probably a 600 grit because this is a very small graver and I don't want to take off too much. So now it's time to make sure everything is set up. This is a brand new set, so sometimes they're a little bit sticky. Over time, they're going to become much looser, so don't worry about that. But get it all set up and put it down where you expect it to be on the stone, and take a look at that. Is that what you're intending? The worst thing is if you start grinding on a side that you're not expecting. Okay, so I've brought this up a little bit. Start the... guess here. Go into the 1200 just to give it a nicer finish. Now we've gotten the right facet complete for the shaping grind. I'm going to go and move the graver to the left side so we can shape the left side of the graver. the three tangs are in the middle of the five indexing slots. Go back to the 600. Okay, now we have a 90 degree shaped graver. Once you have the entire graver shaped, and in this case it's a 90 degree graver, we're ready to go to sharpening. The first thing I do is go back and hit the face just to make sure everything is nice and clean, given that we did just modify the entire bottom of the graver. So I have a 1200 grit wheel on here. I'm just gonna give it a kiss here, just to make sure it has a nice finish on it. And again, these are a little bit sticky when they're new. If you do have an issue with that, you can take a small Allen wrench and pop the collet right out. So now that we've done the face and have a nice finish on that, we're gonna go and use our heel portion of our geometry block. So to do that, we're going to line up our tangs and our indexing slots to the three in the middle. You might have to wiggle it a little bit to get it to line up, and then pop it in. So this is the right-hand side. I have a 1200 grit diamond wheel on here, and I am not going to turn it on. For this, I want to just hand do this very small facet, which is going to be a parallel facet. So in this case, right now, the tip is towards me. I want to put it on the wheel and drag it away from the tip. So I will do that. I will put it here and lower it down. Hold everything so that it's in place. Do not have your wheel spinning. Grab it and then pick it up, put it down. I'm going to do this three times. And then I will see how big my heel is. It's a pretty good size. Now I'm going to take this out and move it to the left side. Again, getting the tangs and index slots lined up with the three in the middle. This time, the tip of the graver, that would be the cutting part, is away from me. So I'm going to lower it down on the wheel and drag it towards me. Again, the same three times. Trying to have equal pressure. And I'll take a look. And it looks like they match up. So there we have our 90 degree graver. which we have shaped and put the parallel heels on with our geometry block. So the next time you have to go and sharpen it, you also use the same block, but you don't have to go and do the shaping portion again. You just use the bottom two to put the parallel heels on. And if you need to use the face to touch that up, you use whatever angle corresponds to the angle that you made with your graver for the face. For these geometry blocks, we have them clearly marked on the top. This is a 90 degree graver, and it has parallel heels, which is the P, if you use the 55 degree face block. So if you're using the 55 degree face angle block, this geometry block will give you a 90 degree graver with parallel heels. If you choose to use the 45 degree face block, then the heels that this will give you would be more traditional-like. They won't be parallel. If you don't have a hone of some kind, you can still sharpen your gravers using a bench stone. In this case, I have our diamond wheel, and I have the holder for our diamond wheel. So I currently have the face angle block and the tower set up. I'm going to hold the holder and the wheel, lower the graver, and swipe back and forth. Now, you wouldn't want to do this in the same area all the time, but you can then pick it up, move around a little, hold it in place, and go for the next. This way, you can work your way around using all parts of the diamond wheel, and you can get a really nice finish on your graver all by hand. If you have a pre-shaped graver, in this case I have a velour flat graver, and you just want to put the face on it, you can pick any of the angles. 60 is the angle that these come at. So I can put the graver in there with the tangs aligned in the three middle of the index slots. And then I can easily move so that if I need to sharpen this flat or I want to use it, I can make sure that the face is a nice 60 degrees. Speaking of flats, we also have a 15 degree heel geometry block. So if you have a flat and you want to put a 15 degree facet for the heel on it, you can line it up again with the top up and the three tangs in the index slots. And then you can put it on there. And I would probably drag it backwards. And that puts on a really nice facet at 15 degrees.